When a child is identified with an elevated blood lead level, or EBLL, in HUD-assisted housing, a thorough investigation for the sources of lead exposure for this child is required. This is called an environmental investigation, or an EI. Along with a lead-based paint risk assessment of the primary residence, an EI helps determine if there are other sources besides the primary residence. This is accomplished through careful interviews to identify locations or other sources of exposure. This may include visits to other locations where the child spends time. A certified risk assessor is responsible for the environmental investigation, and these responsibilities may be shared by public health, environmental, and housing agencies. For example, the health department may complete an investigation and provide case management for the child. In our example interview, the public housing authority has hired the risk assessor to perform the risk assessment and environmental investigation. An EI is required under HUD assistance programs within 15 calendar days of receiving the report of a child with a verified elevated blood lead level. A verified level is from a venous blood test. One part of the EI is a parent or resident interview with a set of questions aimed at understanding if and how the child may be exposed to sources of lead in their primary residence. The risk assessors can use the resident questionnaire for investigating a child with an EBLL found in Chapter 16 of the HUD guidelines. The questionnaire includes information on the family, housing conditions, use of the unit, and behavior of the child and other possible sources of exposure.
Hi, Tamara. I'm Terrell. I'm the risk assessor performing the environmental investigation.
Hello.
Let's just get started. I have some questions that I want to ask, and then based on your responses, we'll determine how we will move forward with the investigation. Is that fair?
Okay.
Okay. What is your child's name?
Her name is Carly.
Carly. Okay, how old is Carly?
She's 4 years old.
She's 4 years old. Where do you think she may have been exposed?
Well, at home, she usually plays a lot in the basement area.
Mm-hmm.
And she has her own room. She goes to my mom's house every now and then, and she also spends a lot of time at my sister's house. In the babysitter's house.
Okay. Your home, do you own or rent?
I rent.
You're renting your home?
Yes.
Okay. Are there any subsidies involved at all?
Yes, I have a Section 8 voucher.
You have a Section 8 voucher. Okay.
Yes.
So you indicated that your daughter was sometimes cared for away from home, at your mother's house. What about daycare? Does she attend any daycare centers or preschools?
Well, she was at a daycare center not far from here.
Okay.
But I recently took her out.
Conducting a parent or resident interview is more than just asking a set of questions. It takes a special skill set to be a successful interviewer. Successful interviewers are personable and trustworthy.
And the reason I'm asking you all of these questions, because we're just trying to figure out where the exposure may have come from. It's possible that we can do all the testing here and not identify, so it gives us a broader scope of where we can potentially look.
So, I mean, is this going to be really hard to figure out where she may have been exposed?
We're going to move very quickly so that we can see if we can make a determination of where the exposure may have occurred, okay?
Okay.
A good interview requires establishing a rapport with those being interviewed to assure that not only do all the questions have responses, but the responses are honestly given, respectfully received, and meet the needs of the investigation and are accurately recorded. The interviewee, in this case the parent, is the expert on their house and child. Interviewers can help connect the reason why the parent's knowledge is important for the investigation.
So you indicated that she has a play area downstairs. Where else does she like to play?
She does play downstairs a lot. Every now and then, like, if she have a friend over, they like to play hide-and-go-seek, and sometimes they'll run into the closets and things. But pretty much the downstairs area, maybe in the living room, and then just in her room.
Okay, so when they play hide-and-go-seek, are there any areas that are totally off-limits?
Not really. Like I said, sometimes they'll, you know, hide under the bed or in the closet and things like that.
All right. So she does have access to the whole house. So when we're doing our investigation, we'll just make sure we check everywhere so that we can rule out any areas.
The interviewer must be respectful in all contacts with the parent or resident and answer any questions they may have.
No, I'm just wondering, you know, where she could have been exposed to lead at, because we pretty much do everything safe around the house. So, and then my mom, her house is newer, so I couldn't imagine that that's where she was exposed. And I'm just worried, that's all. So I'm hoping that you all will have some answers really soon.
Yes, it's understandable that you're worried. That's why we're moving really quickly. That's why we're here so quick, and we're going to get the investigation underway right away, do the testing, look at the results, and see if there's anything readily apparent that we can share with you regarding potential exposure.
All questions asked and responses received during an interview should have a planned use within the project and should be passed to those who need them to meet the project goals.
How about a favorite cup? Does she have a favorite cup?
She does have a, she likes the anime character, so I have a little favorite mug with, she likes to drink out of that. So, but I make sure that we clean it and sterilize it and everything, so I don't think that would be an issue with it.
That's just something else to test. Some products made overseas may have lead in it. So it just gives us an opportunity to test it and rule it out as a source.
It is important to have a way to accurately record both answers to direct questions as asked and other potentially useful information that may surface during an interview. The Lead Safe Housing Rule requires that if lead hazards are identified during the environmental investigation, they must be addressed and clearance completed by certified firms within 30 calendar days of the designated party receiving the environmental investigation results. The owner is responsible for repairs, which must be performed by a certified renovator or lead abatement contractor, depending on the state or local regulations.
I guess I'm just wondering, is there anything that we need to do in the meantime until the results come back?
Live your life as normal. You have the Protect Your Family from Lead in the Home. If you haven't read it recently, I urge you to take another look. There are lots of suggestions and ideas in that.
I skimmed through this when we first moved in, but it's been so long. So I'll take a look at this. And if I have any questions, should I reach out to you or the doctor? Who should I reach out to?
Well, if you have any questions about lead, absolutely reach out to the doctor. If you have any questions about the investigation, the risk assessment, call me.
Okay. Well, thank you so much. Just hope we can get to the bottom of this.
We're going to do our best.
Thanks.
Thank you.